In this video, I'm going to be demonstrating the MSA, or middle superior alveolar injection technique. So, the MSA is going to anesthetize the mesobuccal root of the first maxillary molar along with the second premolar and first premolar, the buccal periodontium and buccal tissue. It does not anesthetize lingual tissue at all, so just the mesobuccal root of the first molar, if that's not anesthetized with the PSA, and then the two premolars, pulpal tissue on the two premolars, the mesobuccal root of the full first molar, and then the buccal periodontium. So our site is going to be right at the height of the mucobuccal fold, parallel to the second bicuspid. So we're just going to try and parallel our syringe to that second premolar and aim for the apice of that second premolar at the height of the mucobuccal fold. So to prepare our site, the first thing we want to do is dry the tissue. So you want to dry the tissue and remove any debris that might be in the injection area. So just a nice gentle dab with the gauze to remove any debris or any excess saliva. So that's just going to help clean the area, and then we're going to apply our topical anesthetic. So you just want a little bit of topical anesthetic on the tip of a cotton tip applicator. You don't want a big glob. You don't need a lot of excess because it's powerful and it does what it's supposed to. So you're just going to place the topical at the site for a 2-minute period of time, 1 to 2 minutes. Just let that sit and soak in so that the patient's getting nice and numb. And we're gonna say that's been 2 minutes. I'm gonna remove my topical and I'm going to dab any excess off, or I can rinse it off with some water and rinse the area. I'm just going to dab it and the site looks good. So now we're going to go ahead and give our injection. Again, I'm just going to parallel the second bicuspid and at the height of the mucobuccal fold, I'm going to identify my point of penetration, which is going to be right here. And I'm going to penetrate to a depth of about 6 to 12 millimeters. You just want to be above the apice of the tooth to get good anesthesia. I'm going to go ahead and aspirate. And I'm going to rotate my syringe about a quarter turn, and I'm going to re-aspirate. And both of those aspirations are negative. I'm looking at where the cap is, and then I'm going to go ahead and deposit there. And when you withdraw, you want to withdraw kind of quickly in one line. If you see bleeding at the site, you want to apply pressure with a gauze and hold to prevent hematoma. And that's the MSA.